Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to be looking at how to create some cinematic contrast in DaVinci Resolve. Just real quick, my name is George and I'm a color grade artist and a nomad, and I do DaVinci Resolve tutorials as well as some other color grading videos on this YouTube channel. So if you are interested in color grading or DaVinci Resolve, consider subscribing to my channel for tutorials like this and others in the future. So I have this shot here of these two little girls in a sunflower field out in a somewhat overcast day, and the shot is originally in Rec 709. I got it from Envato Elements, which is a site with a lot of stock footage or stock photos and a lot of assets for video creators. It's a great site and a great resource if you're a color grade artist and you want to have basically unlimited footage to be able to practice on or even create like spec videos or color grade demos. Also, if you cannot afford Art Grid, which can be a little expensive, I've actually found that the filmmakers who upload their footage to Art Grid are also now starting to, or have been, uploading their footage to Envato Elements, so you can find that same footage on there. So if you are interested in having access to this enormous library of all kinds of different footage, then there's a link down in my description through which you can sign up. So I have this shot here and I've loaded my Kodak 23:3 cinematic power grade into it and made some adjustments just to get a good starting point. But you do not need it for these techniques that I'm going to show you. You can apply these techniques that I'm going to show you to any other node tree, to any other shot that you're using. So I've applied the power grade and just made a few adjustments to give us a good standard cinematic look. I adjusted the exposure by lowering the highlights. I lowered the opacity on this subtractive saturation node, which gives us some nice cinematic color density in certain hues in our shot. And then I went into the skin key node and just adjusted our skin tones a little bit, made them a little bit more red. And then after that, I applied a cyan adjustment to the highlights in the shot. And that got me to a good starting point. And I'm gonna delete these nodes. I'm gonna select this film LUT node here and then create a node after that. And then I'll rename this shadows. So what I'm going to do in this first node here is make a selection of the darkest parts of my image. And I'm going to do that by going to the qualifier, turning off the hue and saturation controls, grabbing the high and bringing it down. I'm also going to select Shift H so I can see what I'm selecting. And I'm just going to scroll down. I'm going to set the highlight softness to 5. And that'll give us a nice roll off between what we're selecting and what we're not selecting. And then I'm going to grab this high control and then just decide where I want to put it. So I'm just keeping an eye on my subject's faces here, and I like that I'm selecting a little bit of the natural shadows that her cheekbone is creating, and that's just going to help create some definition in her face when I start to actually make the contrast adjustments. And I'm liking that, so I'm going to hit Shift H to come out of that. From here, I'm going to go over to my primaries panel, and down in the shadows control, I'm going to grab that and bring it down just a little bit. I'll also bring up my waveform so I can see what I'm doing to the darker parts in my shot. So I'm going to grab the shadow control and just bring it down, finding that sweet spot. I'm keeping an eye on areas like this dark part here. I'm also looking at the contrast between this dark part in her hat and this brighter spot up here. And if I hit Command D, you can see the adjustment that I'm making here. I'm also going to set my blur radius to 8 as well as my denoise. And those are just some good ballpark settings when using the qualifier with 10-bit footage. And with that being said, I will mention that this shot is a 10-bit shot, and it's really not recommended that you use the qualifier tool with 8-bit shot, just because 8-bit footage doesn't have as much information as 10-bit footage does, and the qualifier tool might start to break up your footage and cause some really nasty effects in your shot that you don't want. So if you're working with 8-bit footage, it's not recommended. So now that I've adjusted the shadows in my shot, I want to adjust the highlights. So what I'm going to do is go over to the shadows node, right click, go down to add node, and then add outside node. And if I hit Shift H, we can see that it's just creating an inverted mask of what we selected in this node here. So now that we have our selection here, I'm gonna hit Shift H to come out of that. I'm gonna come down to my highlights control, and then I'm gonna turn it up just a little bit. That's good there. And then I'll rename this highlights. If I select these two nodes and then hit Command D to turn them off, we can see now that we are adding some nice contrast to the image. It's helping the skin in our subjects here pop. And just with that technique where you create a node and then using the qualifier node, select your shadows as opposed to just adjusting the contrast here and then the pivot. This is just a more sort of selective way of doing exactly that. Now that I've adjusted my highlights, I'm gonna add another node and I'm gonna rename this vignette. And what we're gonna do is create some more separation between our subjects here and the background. So I'm gonna go down to our Power Windows panel, create a circular power window, zoom out a little bit, and then I'm gonna hit Shift H to see my selection. I'm gonna feather it out all the way and then just place it exactly where I want. And now we can see that everything that's in here is being selected and the outside is not being selected, but I want the inverse of this. So I'm gonna go down here and invert the mask and make a few more adjustments to the mask. And that's good right there. I'm gonna hit Shift H to come out of that. And so here's what I'm gonna do in this node here. I'm gonna start off by lowering the contrast. I'm going to turn off the power window so we can get a better shot of what's going on. And now I'm going to turn this node on and off and you can see what's going on. We're just removing all this contrast that we have going on in the background, which can sometimes be a distraction to the eye. If there's something that you're trying to emphasize in your shot or bring attention to, then removing contrast from everything else that you don't really care about in the shot can help do that. So I'm going to bring up the contrast just a little bit. Now that I've lowered the contrast, something else I'm going to do is I'm going to go down to the highlights control and bring it down just a little bit. And that's good right there. And that's just helping to lower the luminance of everything else again. And as you can see, we're just really helping the eye land immediately on our subjects here in our shot. If you are ever using this technique, there is one more thing that you can do. And that is to lower the saturation a little bit. You don't want to go too much because that might create an effect that you're not trying to achieve. If you lower it just a little bit, it can just help a little bit more in separating your subject from the background. And I'll just leave it there. So I'm going to select these three nodes and turn them on and off to see the effect that we're getting. And you can see that we are getting some nice pop right here in the center of our frame with our subjects. And then the background still looks good, but because of the tiny little adjustments, the background is a little less distracting. So now that we've set this up, I'm going to go back into the shadows node and bring down my shadows a little bit more. And likewise, I'll go into the highlights and bring them up. Right there. Now that I've created the definition and the luminance values in my subject and in the entire shot, I want to adjust the overall luminance of the shot and where everything sits on my waveform. So I'm going to go to the end of my node tree here. I'm going to add a node and just rename it global. And then using my highlight control, I'm just going to bring it down. And set my brightest point to around 896 IRE. And play around with it, just seeing where I like it. And that's good right there. And it's just helping to bring everything down and sort of tie everything together. And if we select all of this, turn it off and on, we can see that we've created some nice contrast in the shot. So real quick, let's just break down what we did. We made a selection of our shadows and then brought them down using the shadow control. And then we created an outside node to get an inverted mask of our first selection here. We adjusted the highlights using the highlight control. And using this highlight control when making general adjustments is really beneficial, as the highlights control works differently than the gain control and the highlights control in the primary wheels. It actually works better in creating a smoother highlight roll off in your shots. After that, we created a vignette, not just adjusting the brightness on the outside of the shot, but also adjusting the contrast and the saturation to help lead the eye towards the middle of the shot to our subjects here. And then we just added a global node to bring everything down and tie everything together. The last thing I want to do is actually move up the grain node in my node tree. And this is because anytime you use the qualifier tool to make a selection in your shot, you want to add the grain after, because the grain is creating some texture in your shot, which can make it a little tricky for you to get a good selection. In this case, we had a really well lit shot out in bright daylight, so it wasn't really that noticeable, but you will definitely notice it in other shots. If you have your grain node set in your node tree before any node where you're using the qualifier, you're gonna get some weird fuzzy artifacts in your shot. So always make sure to set your gray node after all the qualifiers in your node tree. So I'm gonna create a serial node after my global node. I'm gonna hold command and just click and drag the gray node into that node, and that's just gonna switch these two nodes. I'll delete this node here, and that's good there. And that is one way to create some selective contrast in your shot for your cinematic color grades.